Here we are going to solve one problem on disk, and this question came in the year 2011 GATE. So in case of disk related problems, we will be having some common terminologies like your latency time, seek time, transfer time, rotational latency or latency, and then amount of data to be transferred, transfer rate, and so on. So all these numerical figures and values are to be used for solving such problems. So let me discuss the problem at first. An application loads 100 libraries. So that is one information, is 100 libraries. At the startup, loading each library requires exactly one disk access. So 100 libraries means 100 times disk access. The seek time of the disk to a random location is given as 10 milliseconds. So seek time is 10 milliseconds. What is the seek time? To put the read-write head on the proper or desired track is known as the seek time. Rotational speed of the disk is 600,000 RPM. If all 100 libraries are loaded from random locations on the disk, how long does it take to load all libraries? So here we are getting another one, that is the rotational speed. And always remember, from this rotational speed, we can go for the latency, rotational latency calculation. What is the rotational latency? Time required to put our read-write head on the proper or desired sector is the time known as the rotational latency. Here you see the seek time is given, but the rotational latency has not been given. So as a result of that has to be calculated from this RPM. And the consideration has been given, the time to transfer data from the disk block once the head has been positioned at the start of the block may be neglected. That means they are telling that the transfer time can be neglected. So options are given. Now let me start with the solution. So I'm going for the answer. So here you see disk. Here we are having disk transfer time is equal to seek time plus transfer time plus rotational latency. So these are the three factors are there who are to be added to get the disk transfer time. Here we know that we are getting the transfer time here. Here the transfer time is equal to zero. Okay. Here you see, here the transfer time is equal to zero, and here the seek time according to the question given is 10 milliseconds. So you are remaining with only the rotational latency. So that's why I wrote them at first, because they were known and this value has to be calculated. So how to calculate the rotational latency from the rotational speed, that is RPM, 6000 RPM, how to calculate? So you see, rotational speed given as 6000 RPM. I shall calculate time to rotate once. So you see, 6000 rotations for 60 seconds. So one rotation will be 60 by 6000. So that is the figure, that is 60 by 6000. Now I shall calculate rotational latency. Rotational latency is equal to 1 by 2 of this rotation time. Why? Because we are taking the average, because the first sector, for the first sector accessing, I need not to perform any rotation. For the last sector accessing, I require the complete rotation. Then what will be the rotational latency in that case? Let us take the average. Average means 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 of this, what is the value? That is 5 millisecond. Why it is 5 millisecond? Because you see, it is nothing but 6 and 6 is this one. So I am getting this 10. 10 by 2 is 5. So 5 by 1000 second means 5 milliseconds. So in this way the calculation has been done. Okay. So total time to transfer one library is equal to this plus that. Here the transfer time is 0, seek time I have calculated and rotation time I have calculated. So now it is 10 millisecond for the one library. So it is 100 into 15 is equal to 1500 millisecond is equal to 1.5 second. So that is the total time required. Let me check, 1.5 second is this one, so B will be the answer. So in this way the problem can be solved. Always remember, these disk related problems containing transfer time, latency for the sector accessing, that is a rotational latency, seek time, these times will be coming. You should have to find out the all the three values so that you can get the disk transfer time, and then you can do the needful calculations according to the problem demanded. Hope you have learned this particular session. Thanks for watching this video.